I have detected something. I have detected something.
Down we go!
I have detected something.
Whoa, a treasure chest!
Hey, some treasure.
Old Duke doesn't get much better than this.
Hey, some treasure.
Whoa, a treasure chest!
Treasure chest located.
I think we can use that device now.
Are we supposed to get on it?
Ugh, finally.
Do we really have to do all of this?
I have
to
detect
a treasure chest!
Treasure chest.
an opportune chance to rest. I feel something strange from the other side of that door.
Then we should assume our destination lies beyond it.
It could be a trap. Don't let your guard down.
Hello there. Let's have a look-see. Well now, this is wonderful. I'd like you to have this.
I've been waiting for you. Welcome, my old comrades. And my lady, Rosfita.
Sorry, we're not the allies you once knew.
Yes, how foolish of me. From the looks of it, Dr. Noah managed to save Adol and the Crimson King.
Yeah.
He has learned quite a bit working for me, so I'd expect no less from him. Anyway, I'm glad you're all right now.
How can he be so cruel? He doesn't feel bad at all.
What have you been doing here for the last 15 years after you disappeared? You owe me an explanation, Zola.
Same for Asvita. Ever since I succeeded in creating you, I thought to myself, why stop there? Shadowlard attempted to restore Glia with a homunculus army of only the elite. But he lacked ambition. Why settle for only the experiences of the living? But you, Rosvita, are my crowning achievement. A living testament to the prospects of alchemy. Imagine what we could do with all the great heroes and minds of the past. That was my vision. To amalgamate all of their combined wisdom with alchemy.
That's impossible! Papa! You can't!
How did you get all the information about these people that you needed?
Repeating what you did with Rosvita and Anemona would have taken too much time.
That is correct. I had the same concern. That is, until I found you, Adolf Kristen. You not only harbor an abundance of insight from your adventures, but you've also encountered a great many exceptional beings. Among them are beings some would consider to be gods.
No. What have you done?
Through my research, I was able to extract those memories from Adol. My magnum opus is far greater than what Shadowlard could have ever dreamed. With the combined memories of the people Shadowlard and I collected in the prison, and the extraordinary wisdom etched into Adol's soul, I fused all of them into one single being. A being like the gods themselves. No, a being that is superior to the gods. Aprilis, with this god in the Grimwald Nox, all of you can be freed from this curse.
He's lost it. To think that someone could come up with something so egregious.
And tonight, with the Grimwald Nox at its peak, my magnum opus will finally be complete.
That vessel, it's filling up with blue spirits.
Wait, Zola! Is that...
Adol?
He's really gone and done it.
Its power is astonishing.
It's beautiful. O Atra, thou, born from night, I beseech thee, become the guardian of the Grimwald Nox in the god's stead.
Out there. It appears that all of the monsters outside the fortress were annihilated.
What? In an instant?
There's no doubt about it. He wields the power of the gods.
Yeah.
Yes. I'm pleased that it meets your expectations at all. Now, none of you have any need to fight in the Grimwald Nox ever again. You can live unshackled from the curse that has plagued you all your life. Allow me to congratulate you. I am truly happy for all of you. You deserve this.
Papa... Really? But... Can we really trust something this powerful?
There's no way it's that simple.
Would you prefer fighting tirelessly like you have for the past 500 years for the rest of eternity?
Well, no, but...
That is, unless you find joy in being a slave to the Grimwald Nox. Regardless, I have no further need for monstrums. I invited you here as a debt to my old friends, but it's best if you leave now.
I acknowledge that your work has allowed us to survive for so long. However, I want to find a solution that we can all believe in. And I'm willing to wait, if that's what it takes.
Aprilis!
You never change, do you? Why do you insist on suffering with them? Many people once trusted you. And many exploited you as well. This weakness was to blame for your demise, or has it been so long that you've forgotten? No matter how many times I offered you my hand, you refused to take it.
No, Zola,
I don't want to hear it. I'm tired, Rosvita. I don't want to see you get hurt anymore. I didn't spend all those years reviving you just so I could lose you again! Atra. Restrain her.
You can't!
Bastard. There is no need.
What?
Homunculi are no longer necessary as the keepers of the Grimwald Nox. Consequently, I will dispose of them, including their leader, Rosvita.
No!
My purpose is but one. The complete and utter eradication of the source of enmity in the Grimwald Nox.
The source of enmity?
You can't mean...
The animus within Balduk is a pestilence that threatens to consume the rest of the world. To ensure its preservation, the pestilence must be cleansed.
In other words...
You're going to destroy Balduk?
It will be the catalyst of its own salvation.
All the wisdom in the world smashed together and nobody thought this would be the verdict? With the shit I've seen, I almost don't blame him.
But this isn't right!
Zola!
You leave me with no other choice. I will cease Atra's functions.
Zola! Papa!
I must eliminate all hindrances to my objective.
Zola!
You are next. Been selected to be eliminated. But if you obstruct me, I will destroy you as well.
Stand with me and protect Balduk!
Yeah!
Let's go.
Understood.
On!
It's come to this, huh?
Being more powerful than the gods? I like the sound of that.
There's no way we're gonna let you destroy Balduk!
Our fates are the gods, and certainly not yours to decide.
You have all right.
Now,
know we can win. We have to.
Everyone, let us emerge victorious.
Attacks aren't doing a damn thing.
Are you satisfied, homunculi? Soon you may finally be at peace. You have done well for the past 500 years.
Take caution.
Is this the end?
What's happening now?
You did this.
I did. I am your creator. It is truly regrettable that you were a failure. It seems I need to conduct some more tests.
Sova.
I destabilized the force keeping him together. But he's still more powerful than I anticipated. Be careful.
I am. No, it is I. I am.
Breaking down.
He's only barely able to keep the souls intact. He may be vulnerable in this state. Monstrum, prepare for the final assault!
Ready!
Finish this.
You can't approach the
control!
Use caution!
It's too late to back out now!
We can't afford to let this chance go to waste.
Yeah!
this thing just by throwing ourselves at it.
It must have a weakness somewhere.
If it does, my gift will be able to see it.
No.
Did we do it?
What was that?
That was the core of souls that Atra was comprised of. Once it lost the power keeping it fused, it shattered, and the souls began dissipating.
So is it over?
Yes. Atra is no longer a threat. That said, it means that nothing will change. We must continue fighting the Grimwald Nox as we always have.
But Balduk is safe now, at least.
And it'll stay that way, as long as we keep fighting.
I'll do my best to make sure everyone can keep living in peace. The important thing is that we'll do it together.
I will do my part as well.
I'm never getting rid of you guys, am I?
Adol, what do you wish to do? We are souls forged from your memories. Do you wish to free the Monstrums? With all of us here, at this moment, we can stop the Grimwald Nox together.
But without it, the enmity of the people cannot be contained. Because of this, the future of Balduk is uncertain. It may even come to pass that its people will suffer a far worse fate.
But maybe that's how things should be. What does your heart tell you, Adol?
You, of all people, should know. Choice is not always between right or wrong. The only absolute is that the choice must be made.
We'll help you make it come true, Adol. All you need to do is choose.
They shouldn't be trapped by the past any longer.
It is the relic that manifests Lemiri's from enmity. Please raise your sword, Adol. Now, Adol, destroy the egg. By doing so, the Grimwald Nox will cease to exist.
Is a beacon of hope. You've always been able to find it, haven't you?
You've grown so much, Adol. I'm so happy I had a chance to see you again.
No matter how perilous the path before you, you walk up.
Yeah.
think of this as our gift to you. All that you have done for us.
You'll always be watching over you, Abra.
You're finally awake.
What's with you and fainting?
What happened?
It seems you're still a bit out of it.
Is it true you destroyed the Grimald Nox?
A strange voice told us you did.
I no longer feel the presence of the Grimald Nox, nor any Lemuris. I want to believe that it's finally over.
Yeah.
There's nothing to apologize for.
I don't know what I would have chosen if I were you.
I think I might have chosen to keep the Grimald Nox.
Me too. I don't mind having to fight. If it's to protect the ones I love.
However, then there would be no room to change for the better. Not for us, and not for Balduke.
Yeah, you might be right.
With that, our final battle, like all our other battles, ended like nothing had ever happened. After the Victory Day festival concluded, Balduke returned to normal. This was thanks to Warden Valger and Governor General Lindheim resuming their posts. The Glean Hieroglyph Knights were reinstated with a new master from the church. Things weren't exactly the same around Balduke. But little by little, it would regain its spirit. One of the changes was that the Monstrums were never seen again. With the Grimald Nox gone, we had lost our gifts. Aprilis told us that the curse was always tied to the Grimald Nox. There were rumors of the Monstrums' whereabouts, but they went away eventually. Maybe one day, the Monstrums will be forgotten altogether. But in the meantime,
all right, I think I'm all packed up. Perks of traveling light. I prefer bringing memories instead of stuff. You ready to go too, Adel?
Yeah.
Great, perfect timing. You wanted to say goodbye to Carla and Shanta, didn't you? We can do that before we leave.
Adol, my dear, you're not really leaving me, are you? Whatever will I do without you? But I suppose that the original intent of this bar was to help you leave.
That's why it's called the Dandelion, right? A seed that floats into the wind, onto a new journey.
That's right. I knew this day would come, so this is for the best. I I suppose I'll have to hold back my tears and see you off with a smile.
Thank you.
Oh, my darling Adol. I couldn't forget you in 1,000 years.
What are you gonna do with the bar?
I've thought about it, but I can't bear to leave her. I've grown much too fond of this place. So I think I'll keep her open. I'll save 2 seats for you at the bar, okay? When you return, she'll be even more gorgeous than you remembered.
I'm looking forward to that.
I'd like to express my gratitude as well for everything you've done for this city, Adol.
I still haven't wrapped my head around you being Cardinal Linda. You might be one crafty guy, but you're all right in my book.
I've always had a knack for hiding my identity.
No.
I'm the one who should be apologizing to you. Though my circumstances required it, I was still dishonest about who I was.
I heard that when Lindheim was younger, he worked in the mines for 2 years in secret. In the entire 2 years, nobody suspected that the son of a noble was working amongst them.
I did it to understand the perspective of the people. Being imprisoned with you and escaping was an experience I'll never forget at all.
You've got more guts than the best of us. There's all sorts of characters in the Roman Empire, huh?
Now, I hate to see you leave, but we wouldn't want to keep you. I'd wager there are other people waiting to see you off.
Ah, that's right. We have to go see Carla at the Pendleton Company. Without her, the dandelion would never have happened.
Adol, Dogi, be careful out there, okay?
We'll be wishing for your success and all your future adventures.
Voyons voir. Thank you.
Okay.
Hey. Thank you both for coming.
Didn't know you'd be here too, Krisha.
Carla told me that you'd be stopping by. I, wanted to say thank you one last time. Not long ago, I thought that I'd have to be a monstrum for the rest of my life. But you freed us from the Grimwald's Nox, Adol. Right. I'll make you proud.
So, how are you adapting? You've all returned to your original non-homunculus bodies, right?
Yes. Except for Anemona, of course. But thanks to Dr. Noah, I feel perfectly normal. Well, there is the little problem of all my old memories getting jumbled up. But we've all decided to look to the future, instead of dwelling on the past.
Yeah, that's a good outlook.
I didn't want you to leave worrying about us. Aw. Hey, that's weird. I don't want to say goodbye at all. Can't you stay with me a little longer?
I thought you said you didn't want him to worry, Krisha.
Carla!
Besides, Adol's already done enough for us. Let's not make him do any more. I'm sure that Adol and Dogi have more people they have to see before they go.
I know, but...
I never thought Krisha would take to you so well, given how shy she used to be. On behalf of all of us at Pendleton, thank you for everything you've done. Krisha told me what had happened. You're a hero, Adol.
No.
I mean, it is partially Adol's fault that this all happened to begin with.
You may have a point, but it was my honor to have helped you, nonetheless. From the bottom of my heart, thank you.
Thank you.
Shantae's the one who did all the heavy lifting. Though it's unfortunate a business partner as promising as you is departing. Whenever you decide to return to Balduke, you'll always be welcome at Pendleton.
We might just take you up on that.
Thank you so, so much, Adol. Please, come back to Balduke one day. I'll be waiting for you.
Stay well, Adol, and safe travels.
Adol!
Adol Kristen. At last, I finally found you. Where have you been hiding?
Doesn't she work for the Roman Empire? What does she do again?
Yeah.
So you've uncovered my top secret assignment. I will admit there may have been some truth to your statements from the interrogation. Though I was reluctant to acknowledge it. But now that I have, I realize that you're even more dangerous than I thought. Now you will come quietly back to the prison with me. What?
Adol, show her what Parks gave you. This is one of those times it would come in handy, right?
What's this? An adventuring charter? Cardinal Lindheim's handwriting. How in the world did a reprobate like you get your hands on this? More importantly, when did Cardinal Lindheim return? And what of Chatelard and the others?
Wait, you really have no idea? The Cardinal's been back as the Governor General for a while now. As for Chatelard, he's gone. So the Hieroglyph Knights are restructuring.
I haven't seen any report since I escaped the Hieroglyph Knights and hid underground.
Guess she wouldn't know. She's been under a rock. Literally. Speaking of, I don't mean any offense, but, you kinda stink.
For all I know, you may very well have forged this letter. I must confirm its legitimacy with the Cardinal at once.
Hey!
Listen here, Adol Kristen. If I learn you forged this letter, I'll have you imprisoned once more. You stay right there until I come back.
She's persistent, I'll give her that. But we should probably get going before Deputy Crazy gets back. If we go now, we shouldn't have any problems leaving through the front gate.
Ah, good. It seems we've caught you just in time.
Jules. And Dr. Noah. I'm sorry, Jules. You can't walk anymore after losing your gift, right?
Yep. I got the short end of the stick. My original body has the same disease, too. Maybe I'll find a way to restore the Grimwald Nox so I can have my gift back. Beats being a wet blanket about it.
Good old Jules.
Oh, I have a message from Anamona for you. She said, thank you for everything. Let us meet again.
No frills, straight to the point. That's Anamona for you.
Despite how concise the message was, she did appear sad you were leaving. In any case, I believe the choice she made was for the best. Sola was generous enough to perform one final procedure for her.
Ah, I getcha. So, what's the plan for the Noahs?
About that.
We found a lead on Jules' disease.
Maybe...
The research documents that Zola left behind give me hope that it can. I don't expect him to be cured immediately, but I'm sure we can slow its progression. In fact, he's already doing so well, he insisted on coming to bid you goodbye.
Hey! That's great news, Jules!
Well, I'm not out of the woods yet. We still don't know if I can be cured completely. So, you two really are leaving.
Yeah. I'm sad to say bye too, kiddo.
Are you going to continue your adventures then, Adol? Hey, if I can walk again someday, do you think I could come to visit you?
Yeah.
Really? I'm going to hold you to that. Then you can tell me about all the new things you two have seen on your adventures.
You got it. We'll tell you so many stories, you'll be begging us to stop. In the meantime, make sure you record your own adventures in that notebook of yours. Then we can swap stories next time we meet. Right, Adol?
Then...
I just might do that.
Adol, Dogi, thank you for everything you've done for our family. Jules, Pamela, and I wish you the best on your journey.
We appreciate that. You've done plenty for us, too.
Thank you, both of you. And take care.
Right back at you, Jules. All right, then. Time to go, Adol. Would you look who it is?
Whew. Looks like we just made it.
We've got ourselves an entourage. Did you all come to say goodbye?
Yeah. Both of you have done so much for all of us. The least we could do was send you off in kind. My co-workers also send their regards. Oh, they covered for me at the Coliseum so I could come say goodbye.
Your boyfriend here's a keeper, Yuffa.
Boyfriend? When are you two gonna make it official already? Go! I'm sorry about that. Ood! Cut it out!
That's the Gamberg family for you. Felix has got his work cut out for him.
Thank you for everything, Adol. And for all you've done for our sister, especially.
Your sister's the one who's gotten us out of more scrapes than we can count.
Look, Yuffa's blushing. Hey, you two. What did I just say? I haven't even said goodbye to Adol yet. Well, now it's too quiet.
Hurry it up, woman. Adol's busy, you know.
This city, just as my mother and father did. And I'm glad I can continue living here with my siblings. So thank you for that. For giving us the push we needed. The wounds we've suffered may never heal completely. But I'll keep my head up and smash through every wall that holds me back. As long as we're all smiling, it'll give Mom and Dad a reason to smile down on us too. I'll follow your example, Adol, and keep looking toward the future.
Thank you.
Yeah. Keep it going for us, okay?
You kids take care too. Don't give your sister too much trouble, you hear?
We'll do our best, Ogi.
Bye-bye, Adol.
Don't be strangers, okay?
Best of luck on your travels, both of you.
We'll miss you, but don't look back, okay? We'll never forget you two.
Neither will we. Kristen! Uh-oh. Here comes the warp. Yes. You as well. So, I take it you're leaving? Yeah, that's the plan. Good. That might be for the best. What do you mean? After everything that's happened, the Imperial military's on their way from Rom. A relatively new paranormal investigation division is also involved. Whew, they don't waste any time, do they? You know Ingrid, don't you? She's actually a highly ranked officer in the Imperial Army. She used her connections to request additional support from the Roman military. No idea how she managed to report on all those events while she was in hiding, though. I heard the two of you were the primary suspects in the investigation.
Come on, can't we catch a break?
I am a Roman soldier, so if they require it, I will be obliged to aid them. Anyway, I thought I'd give you fair warning.
Thank you.
You don't need to thank me. A soldier always repays his debts. Stay sharp. Until we meet again, Adol Kristen.
Looks like there's one more person waiting for you.
Heading out, Adol? Now that the Grimwald Nox is gone, the people's fate rests in their own hands. There's a possibility of a far more disastrous war or calamity in the future. That being said, you all risked your lives to pave this new path for Balduk. Now it's our responsibility to ensure it leads to the future this city deserves.
Yeah.
I appreciate the sentiment. We can do no less as the people who live upon this land. You are kind, Adol Kristen. And you are also steadfast. Do you remember when I told you I wished the Monstrums didn't have to fight anymore? It was right before our final battle.
Yeah.
Teasing me now, are you? I had a feeling, Adol, from the moment I met you in the prison, that you would be the one to spark the change that I could only dream of. But I always reserved my expectations.
looking at. You exceeded them anyway. Thank you for freeing the Monstrums. This is the first moment in a very long time that I myself have felt free.
Then...
I'm sure you've spent your life living for the sake of others. Though, I guess I'm not one to talk. But, hey, it might be good for you to take some time to yourself for a change.
Interesting. I can do that now, can't I?
Yeah.
Yes, you're right. Adol, thank you again. For everything. Though it pains me to see you go, I'm glad for you all the same. Goodbye, Adol.
So, where to next, Adol? If you want to stay on the road, we can head towards Garmin. Or if you're pining for the sea breeze, we can take a trip overseas to Bretagne. You really took that dandelion thing to heart, huh? By the way, I've been meaning to ask. You've been on the road for a while now. Ever think about settling down anywhere? Come on, you're killing me, Adol. Well, no sense stopping now. The road suits us better, after all. We made a lot of great memories here, with a lot of great people. Wherever the next destination may be, I hope we meet more folks like that again. Hey, Adol. Look.
Thank you.